Yes.
He entered a not guilty plea, and he's going to be released later this afternoon on bond.
These are some very serious charges. What do you say about his alleged connection to actor Matthew Perry's death?
Well, the connection isn't there, but there was a relationship prior to Mr. Perry's death, and the death itself is obviously tragic. Everybody loved Matthew Perry and Chandler Bing and friends, but it's just a very unfortunate situation. Dr. Plasencia had provided some medical care to Mr. Perry sometime prior to his passing, and it's just an unfortunate situation.
Was it ketamine?
Yes, it was. Mr. Perry was on the ketamine treatment, medically supervised, medically prescribed. And while the U.S. attorney may disagree with Dr. Plasencia's medical judgment, there was nothing criminal at the time. And more importantly, the ketamine that was involved in Mr. Perry's passing was not related to Dr. Plasencia.
It was alleged, though, that he gave the ketamine, the injections, to his live-in assistant to inject him with the ketamine.
There have been a lot of allegations and have not seen any evidence to substantiate or corroborate anything as of yet.
Say, though, when there's a Dr. Chavez listed in the indictment and text messages saying, hey, let's see how much money we can get.
Well, like I said before, the indictment it's an allegation. We haven't seen those text messages. We haven't seen any statements. And time will tell as to what evidence actually is out there. But until that time, Dr. Plasencia is innocent until proven guilty. And any wrongdoing that he may or may not have done under those allegations still was not related to Mr. Perry's untimely death.
How long was...
But obviously, it was very sad to hear, you know, he liked Mr. Perry. And, you know, just like all of us, nobody wanted to see that happen. And it's unfortunate that whatever led to that was, you know, done irresponsibly by other parties.
He's allowed to keep practicing being a doctor. You mentioned the patients he has, but they have to be informed.
That's correct. And that is all as a condition of his release by the court. If the medical board sees differently, they'll take their own action. But for the time being, while he's still not convicted of any criminal wrongdoing, he is allowed to practice medicine with the informed consent of his patients.
Had he been doing ketamine?
I think that was good.
Okay.
The hot sun makes
a little dizzy, right? Okay.